A warm good evening, everyone. It's a great Sunday today. It's the fourth day of the International E-Conclave. Very interesting day because on the last 4 days, we have been, since the last 3 days, we have been speaking about a lot of things about pharmacotherapy related to tobacco cessation. Today, we have the consensus whereby all the moderators from the last three sessions are going to present a short summary. And then we're going to have a great panel discussion with the topmost surgeons from different specialties across the country. So I'll now invite our third key opinion leader from day three.
So thank you so much. And day one and day two was extremely important, but day three was as important. And on the day three, we had a multi-model approach for treatment for tobacco cessation. What we had during the day one was basically on non-NRT, and day two was NRT products. So day three was how to incorporate each and every aspect of that together. So on, if you can just stop sharing for a few minutes and then you will share. So there were four presentations on the first day, and the first presentation was importance of non-pharmacological aids in tobacco cessation or comorbidity management. And that was presented by me as the opening address. And the session was chaired by Dr. J.S.D. Patel. And the important aspect on this presentation, on this in this talk was that we have to incorporate in a the tobacco cessation in a very systematic way. And that is, we have to, it is just not focusing on the tobacco aspect, but also the harms that it has caused to the patient. So it was very nicely put it like A, B, C, D of tobacco cessation. That is A for active motivation and follow-up of the patient. B was for the behavioral therapy. C was for comorbidity management. This is very important aspect of tobacco cessation. Comorbidity management, like these patients would have some of the other problems which was to be taken care, and that needs to be taken care when we are dealing with the tobacco cessation. And that may include nutritional deficiency, the immunity deficiency, the oral cavity is not opening up. That is what submucosal fibrosis because of the SLT. And those aspects were really dealt with in this presentation. So, and of course, the D is for the drug management, that is drugs that includes NRT and non-NRT, and that also needs to be included. So a 7D approach for behavioral therapy as well as for the comorbidity management was given in this talk. And this was a very important thing that which can increase that quit rate of a patient. So that was very important. And the second was the talk was given by Dr. Vishal Chhabra. And this was on biopsychosocial aspect to tobacco cessation. And this was actually chaired by Dr. Shruti Srivastav. Dr. Shruti Srivastav has been running a tobacco cessation center for a very long time, almost 10 years. And they have also developed a very systematic approach for tobacco cessation. And that is what was, as the chairperson, Dr. Shruti Srivastav emphasized on that, we should have a systematic approach so that it can be scaled and it can be easily taken care by any of the doctors around, even the young doctors who are into the training, so that the tobacco cessation intervention is in a standardized form. So Dr. Vishal Chhabra, as a speaker, he spoke about the biopsychosocial aspect to tobacco cessation, and that is something very important, and that is coming up. You know, there are three components of tobacco cessation that needs to be taken care if you really want to have a good quit rate. See, the important aspect that was dealt was by Dr. Vishal Chhabra was that these three component, that is the psychological component, the physical component, and also the social component also needs to be addressed. And that was very nicely put forth by Dr. Vishal Chhabra. And he emphasized that when we are doing our counseling, when we are doing our medications, all these three needs to be taken care so that when we deal with the patient, these are certain things that needs to be taken. So then the third presentation was by Dr. Pooja Patwardhan from the United Kingdoms. And the United Kingdoms, this the presentation was experience with multimodal treatment in family practice. And this was actually chaired by Dr. M.S. Bhatia, who is the head of the department, and Dr. M.S. Bhatia, of secretary at G.B. Pant. So he also stressed basically on the most important aspect that when we are looking at tobacco cessation and the entire family is involved. So taking care of the family members is also how the family members need to behave, how they have to talk to the patient, what are the various the pitfalls, what are the various roadblocks that these patients might be facing. It can be just related to the family as well. So all those aspects needs to be taken care of when we are doing a multimodal approach. So this was a very important thing that was spoken to by Dr. Pooja Patwardhan from UK. She is a very renowned tobacco cessation specialist from working in the United Kingdoms and working extensively and with the families on tobacco cessation, and has a very good quit rate. So this was what was spoken to in that in the third talk. And the fourth talk was by Dr. Vasanthi Jirge from KLE Dental College, and she is a dental surgeon and has been running a tobacco cessation center at the KLE Dental Hospital at Belgaum. And this session was chaired by Dr. Rajeshwar Nath Saran, who is a professor at NEHU, that is Northeastern University Health University. And Dr. Vasan Jirge was very emphatic on the fact that tobacco, when it comes to tobacco cessation, the most important aspect that a tobacco cessation specialist, or for that matter, any doctor who sees a patient with who has a history of tobacco should peep into the mouth of the patient. Because this is the commonest area where the patient gets a disease. And this is what we can have a pre-malignant lesions, or we can have a frank cancer in the oral cavity. And India has got the highest tobacco related oral cavity disease, and we have got the highest number of oral cavity cancers. So this was something that was very nicely dealt with Dr. Vasanthi Jirge, that we have to really peep into the oral cavity and do a systematic examination of the oral cavity along with tobacco cessation. She had a specifically, she talked about this, that people from across all specialty, whether it is cardiology, whether it is pulmonology, whether it is dental, oncology, or anywhere, if they do see a patient who has got a tobacco habit, they should definitely either do a self-examination or do an examination of the patient of the oral cavity themselves, or at least refer the patient to a dental surgeon or a specialist who understands or who can do an oral cavity examination. And this needs to be documented, and this has to be followed up. Along with tobacco cessation, the oral cavity lesions needs to be followed up and or treated properly so that we can definitely get a good results. And this was spoken with by Dr. Vasanthi, and this was actually emphasized by Dr. Rajeshwar Nath Saran, who has been working in the molecular biogenetics for many years, and for almost 37 years, as he said, they have been doing a lot of biogenetic studies on the oral cavity, and specifically on SLT, that is smokeless tobacco, that is so rampant in India. So this was again emphasized and properly put, and that every tobacco cessation has to be included, the oral cavity examination has to be included. And if we can do more to that, maybe that would be better. So this is something very important. And this was the four important talks that was we had on that day. And there was a chairperson's address, and where it was very nicely put that if we really want to have a tobacco cessation in a proper way, then we have to include almost all the comorbidities that may be associated, which may probably take care of the withdrawal symptoms that may be that would come up with the when we do a tobacco, means when we start doing, when the person stops taking tobacco. And this is something what's very important. So then following this, we had the panel discussion. Suti, now you can share the slides. So we had the panel discussion. So in the panel discussion, the topic was basically limited to the focusing. Can you go to the previous slides, Suti? Previous slides. Yeah. Oh, is this done? The panel? No, this is one, right? So this was important on that day that it was focused on in this panel discussion. The outcomes of this panel discussions was something like this: 50% of the tobacco consuming population wants to quit but can't do it by themselves. So they need, there has to be important tobacco cessation specialist around the corner to help them. Addictive nature of the drug and numerous underlying and overriding factors make it the reason to start and difficult to quit. Of course, it is there. Dental surgeons and family physicians need to ask every patient about tobacco history. NRT is a safe product and easy to advocate. Pick up the disease early. Next, please. So, NRT lozenges work well. Okay, this spray can cause irritation. NRT is a very effective tool. Treat immediate disease like cancer, simultaneously start tobacco cessation, referral by every attending specialist. I emphasize on that. Very brief advice by physician is very important, and health belief models. Children's health as an important factor. Lack of confidence is cause of failure by the patient. So this was actually in a discussion. This topic came up. Lack of confidence by the patient, and also lack of confidence by the doctor, because of the when the doctor is not skilled enough to treat these patients. Strong support by various matters like quitline, family and social startups, and reaching rural area is a challenge. And of course, it can be done with proper guidance and proper incorporation of other people. Next, please. So another very important factor when panel discussion, it was about the technology to amplify tobacco cessation. So Rishabh, who is basically an IIT graduate and from Kharagpur, and he has developed this tobacco cessation app, which incorporates all the
videos. Yes. So during the panel discussion, we had the discussion about the role of technology that it can play in an effective tobacco cessation. So it was pointed out that yes, technology can amplify the availability and accessibility to network of cessation experts and quit coaches, and a scientific approach can be followed, a standardized approach where patients can log in their cravings, do a self-assessment, and also have also through this application there can be rich motivational tips that can be pushed to the tobacco addicts for an effect to motivate them from moving from peak contemplation to contemplation, as well as motivating them to stay in a state of quit. And of course, establish finally a data-driven and an evidence-based approach so that we can improvise in the future and make the quitting approach or the quitting methods in a more effective with better quit rates. So this was being discussed during the panel discussion.
Yeah, thank you so much, Rishabh. I think with that, we come to the end of the summary from all the key opinion leaders from day 1, 2, and 3. I'm sure that all our panelists who are here with us today would have a fair overview of what was being discussed on non-NRT, NRT, as well as on the multimodal approaches for tobacco.